Hello everybody, it's the Historical Gamer once again, and today we're going to be taking a first look at a game that comes out a little bit later today, called Strategic Mind, the Spectre of Communism. This is a game that's actually the third game in the Strategic Mind series, and it feels like it's kind of the fourth game in this sort of iteration. This is a game that is developed by Starny Games, I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing that right. And they have developed similar games called Panzer Strategy, which came out in August of 2018. Then the first of the Strategic Mind series, which came out in October 2019. That was Strategic Mind the Pacific. Earlier this year, Strategic Mind Blitzkrieg came out in May. And now Strategic Mind the Spectre of Communism is coming out here in mid-November of 2020. They've also announced Strategic Mind Fight for Freedom for Q1 of 2021. So these folks are very prolific. They are cranking out these games quickly. And I would say one of the things that kind of struck me about this game, and perhaps one of the reasons I haven't tried these out in the past, is whenever I saw screenshots of them, it looked very much like... it doesn't look exactly like Panzer Corps 2, but it looks like it's a Panzer Corps 2 or Panzer Corps style of turn-based, hex-based, sort of abstracted battle games. And frankly, I've had a little bit of enough of that. You know, the tactical battles in Panzer Corps as part of an overarching campaign is just something that, you know, I've been playing since I was young. I played the original Panzer General on PlayStation 1. And so I had kind of tired of that style of game by this point. But one of the things that did draw me in, which I think is interesting, is the fully 3D cutscenes with different generals and figures. That seems to be one of the things that these guys do that is a little bit unique, shall we say. That doesn't mean the cutscenes are good, mind you. I was watching a compilation of the cutscenes from Strategic Command Blitz or Strategic Mind Blitzkrieg, which is Strategic Mind the Pacific basically focuses on the Pacific Theater. Obviously, Blitzkrieg focuses on the German invasions, and you're fighting basically from the side of the Germans. I think you're basically Franz Halder in the game. And so I was watching like a compilation of these different cutscenes with like your character and Goering and Hitler, and it was just like laughably bad, but also kind of funny that they tried to do something like that. They probably could use better voice actors. They might be the actual developers themselves. I'm not sure. But it was kind of fun to watch and kind of chuckle at. And so that was one of the reasons I figured, hey, listen, they're going to do the Spectre of Communism. I've seen some screenshots of Stalin and others. Maybe that would be something I'd want to take a look at. And so that's what we're going to do today. So we're going to go ahead and jump into a new game. You can see here that looks like there's just one campaign, the USSR campaign. There's a little bit of voiceover here in the background. They're kind of just reading this main menu to me. Basically, it's giving me an overview of the Soviet Union and sort of its formation. And at the end of it, it's telling us that we take the role of Georgy Zhukov, a talented Russian officer who made it through the purges, Stalin's purges, alive, but who now faces a future of unprecedented danger and difficulty. You must strike a precarious balance between Stalin's will and the Soviet Union or Soviet soldiers' lives. Above all else, you must ensure the motherland's survival against all enemies. It's your duty to ensure the Soviet people live to see another day. So I'm curious how much like role playing there is in this game, and how much like ability you have to like make decisions. You know, I've seen the cutscenes with the previous game, and it didn't seem to me like there was a lot of like interaction or opportunity. But I'm curious. The write-up at least makes it sound like it's a little bit role-play, so let's see. Let's jump right in. We'll play reasonable difficulty. I have not played this before. I'm literally jumping straight in fresh, so I'm not even going to try with the tutorial. This is just a true first look, first impression type game. Real quickly, everybody, this cutscene is going to last about 4 minutes, so if you are, I don't have a way to just give you an option to skip ahead, so if you are interested in just skipping through these cutscenes because they are a little bit lengthy, rejoin the video at the at the 8 minute and 14 mark to see the start of the battle.
Very talented officer.
Thank you for your trust, Comrade Voroshilov.
Until recently, I was planning to promote you to Comcorps rank.
Why did you change your mind, Comrade Voroshilov?
Our ever-vigilant state security has uncovered some horrific facts about you, comrade.
You have been spying for both Japan and Poland. I have signed confessions from traitors to the state that prove it. Confess your crimes.
What is this nonsense? I served the Soviet Union faithfully and honorably.
You can lie to your cellmates, Rokossovsky. You are under arrest. The punishment for high treason is death.
Whoa. All right, jumping right into the Soviet purges.
This is your last chance. Tell us who else was in on this conspiracy of yours.
I am innocent. I am not going to falsely accuse my comrades.
You have only to sign this confession to avoid the worst consequences. Well, if you are not with us, then you are against us. Let it be on your head.
Oh no. I don't know anything. Is this a general who was
Ready?
Historically purged? I'm guessing yes.
Fire!
Okay.
Comrade Zhukov, I have always considered you a very talented officer.
Thank you, Comrade Voroshilov.
These are troublesome times. The Motherland needs more such exemplary officers.
Unfortunately, Comrade Voroshilov, as we have seen, not all exemplary officers are truly loyal to the Motherland.
Comrade Zhukov, the Japanese Imperial Army has suddenly invaded our ally, the Mongolian People's Republic. They started out with some border clashes, but now they are trying to grab territory.
It is our sacred duty to protect our socialist Mongol brothers. We must teach these Japanese militaries a harsh lesson.
Comrade Zhukov, I order you to travel to Mongolia at once. Inspect our troops there. Take over operational command if necessary.
It is an honor, Comrade Voroshilov.
Good luck, comrade. I will be waiting for some good news for a change.
I also will be waiting for reports of your diligent and loyal service to the Motherland, Comrade Zhukov.
Okay.
Ready? Aim! Fire!
You will sign the confession, Rokossovsky. Or next time, we shoot you for real.
Save your breath, comrade. I won't betray my fellow officers.
We shall see, comrade. Take him back to his cell.
Okay, well, that was a lot of back and forth to start. We're going to fight the Japanese in the border clashes there, which Zhukov had
Comrade
some
Zhukov,
famous victories against
ago,
the Japanese there.
The
but that was a lot of interesting dialogue there. I'm not sure. The voiceover work uses a little could use a little bit of work, but it was still fun.
With a special order, Comrade Stalin has appointed
as
you,
fun as purges and you know whatnot can be.
Your men are deployed in Mongolia.
Comrade People's Commissar for Defense, please brief me on the operational situation.
The Japanese are attacking from the puppet state Manchukuo. They have violated the Mongolian border.
Okay, so this appears to be, obviously, as I said, a hex-based game. Interesting looking terrain. I don't know if I like it or not. There's a lot of color, a lot of vibrancy to it. But it's also kind of maybe a little washed out. Like, there's a lot of different color, but it's all very green and brown and whatnot. So we'll have to take a look and see, you know, kind of where we land here. Okay, can I just...
Thank you for the information.
Great. Can we just fight? Must call in reinforcements at this moment. I'm desperate in need of tank units.
The first reinforcements will arrive tomorrow. But for now, you will have to kill the enemy with the forces you have. Our bridgehead must remain in our hands at all costs.
Okay, so we have to hold the bridgehead. We get reinforcements tomorrow.
As soon as the opportunity arises, counterattack and eliminate the samurai threatening our bridgehead.
Okay, so we've got to hold the bridgehead here. I don't know. It looks like these units are 10 out of 10. They've got green fuel, green ammo. I'm assuming that indicates how much fuel and ammo they have here. Looks like we've got a BT-5 tank unit, a 45mm anti-tank gun, 120mm probably artillery piece, right? Although it looks like it could be anti-tank.
Core units allocated for one mission only. While the core units will accompany you throughout the campaign.
Okay, so this has a core, non-core unit set up, just like Panzer Corps does.
These units are the ones which should be under your primary protection.
We've got one unit of infantry as well. Okay, artillery and anti-tank gun. So yeah, it does tell me over here on the right the type of unit it is. So if we click on this unit down here on the bottom, on the right it gives me information about the unit. You can see this is an HQ tank, so a headquarters tank. It's a BT-5, so it has a headquarters skill that gives me... I'm not sure what it does. It also allows embarkation of units on it. It looks like it has 5 out of 5 ammunition, so it stores up to 5 ammunition. I'm assuming that means it can fire or engage 5 times before it has to resupply. It also has 25 out of 25 fuel, which I'm also guessing indicates hex range, and then 7 out of 7. I'm guessing that's how many units can fit on board it.
Ammunition and fuel icons next to unit strength
okay.
allow you to quickly
This scenario is pretty much like a tutorial, but I don't want to just like have you guys listen
Stalin's
to
tank
it the whole time.
Have arrived.
Subcaliber shell, prestige cost per attack 3. So you can get a more expensive shell. That's interesting. You can spend prestige for more expensive shells. You can see up here on the top, prestige is a resource for acquisition of units, equipment. It also is used for upgrade and reinforcement of units. It also gives us command points. So we have a maximum of 34. We have 4 that are deployed in core units right now, and an income of 30.
These are ideal for rapid offensive and open
terrain. Okay, I don't
However,
need to...
However, they are vulnerable in close quarters to the infantry units
okay, whatever.
In difficult terrain, such as cities,
let's see
mountains,
here.
Forests,
so
swamps,
I'm assuming I can buy more units, right?
Infantry units.
Unit acquisitions. So we've got BT-5s. There are BT-7s that in theory could be purchased, it looks like. You can just search by regular or conscript units, by recon, by tank, artillery, anti-aircraft, anti-tank, fighter. Ooh, we've got some I-16s. Tactical bombers. And an armored train. That's interesting. I wouldn't mind another tank, so maybe we should buy a BT-7. It's going to cost 294 prestige. So it's kind of expensive. I'm also going to maybe buy a regular infantry unit here. They're a bit cheaper at 95. So we'll add one regular infantry unit and one BT-7. I'm not sure what the deployment how the deployment works. Maybe they arrive at the end of the turn.
Understood.
Oh shit. No. I didn't want them to move. I right clicked. Why is right click move?
Motherland's armor.
That was not intended.
Tank crew awaiting orders.
There's no apparent way to undo move. We'll do that. All right, so it also shows us that there's some Japanese infantry in front of us. There's also a question mark over here, so I guess we're just going to engage the Japanese infantry here. Looks like it's saying we're going to do 1 damage to the enemy, and we should lose nothing of our own, I'm assuming.
Tank crew on standby.
So apparently I right click on it, I attack there. It looks like we actually took 2
infantry
of them
is good
out.
For assaulting the enemy positions after the artillery and air bombardment.
All right, let's use our artillery here.
Cities, mountains,
so you can see their artillery from
positions.
A distance took
a
out a substantial amount of
the
enemy.
Target for the enemy assault.
My anti-tank guns can't really target these guys.
Quiet.
So we'll just attack with our infantry here.
That one's done fighting.
And so the enemy is destroyed. So we lose 1 hit point on our infantry there.
Heavy equipment. Units with heavy equipment.
Okay, this is getting annoying. I wonder if I can turn that off. I don't see an option for the tutorials in any event.
Artillery is the basis of the firepower of your forces.
Okay.
It can
so it looks like
fortifications
we can only... I don't know if we can attack multiple
it's
times in a turn.
As it provides fire support to the ground units within its range.
Doesn't look like I can fire multiple times at them.
Range, which allows you to destroy the enemy troops from
afar.
I'm going to
move this infantry up here on top of this hill, move my anti-tank guns forward here,
so it needs to be protected.
And then use my anti-tank guns against what looks like Japanese armored cars or vehicles of some sort.
Death to all tyrants.
Says unknown amount of damage.
We die together.
Guns of the Soviet Union.
Ready to roll all over them.
Quiet. Comrade Commander is speaking.
Okay. All right. Well, I think that's all I can do for this turn. It is this. You can see here there's base information as well. So if we zoom out here, we can see there are multiple bases throughout the map. You can see there's Japanese-held hexes. There's other Soviet-held hexes back here behind the actual front lines. Looks like we've got an airfield back here. We've got a supply hub. I'm not entirely sure what all of these do, but presumably they influence your prestige or your resources that allow you to purchase more things. It does look like there's infantry back here as well. These are Mongolian troops, which it doesn't look like I'm allowed to command. Those are the troops that the Japanese are attacking. There also appear to be some Japanese troops on the other side of the river over here that might move south on our bases over here, so we might have to consider defending back there. But for the moment, anyway, you can see, I'm assuming this is reflecting a supply line of some sort, because it all does flow back to this depot here. Meanwhile, I don't have the option to deploy any new troops yet, so I'm going to wait until the next turn. I guess we'll go ahead and end the turn and see what the Japanese have in store for us. Looks like we took 3 hit points out of that enemy vehicle. They're driving around us.
With the numbers above the unit being
attacked.
For grounded.
Your reinforcements, Comrade Zhukov, as requested. I kept my word.
Thank you.
Okay, great. Reinforcements have arrived. Also, it looks like there's an enemy tank here that moved forward. Our anti-tank guns engaged the enemy automatically when they moved into range, so that was good to see, I suppose. I'm going to go ahead and use my artillery here, which, by the way, looks like it's entrenched on its own against these enemy vehicles here on the flank. And then I'm going to use my infantry here against this armored car. And we destroyed that enemy unit. Meanwhile, my anti-tank guns apparently are going to go 2-2 against the enemy tanks. My armor is actually more effective than theirs is. So I'm going to go ahead and attack here. We lost 1, they lose 2, so they're down to 3. And then my anti-tank guns hopefully will finish these guys off. Not quite. They still have one.
You can't run from a shell.
They still have one more hit point left in that armored unit. Meanwhile, we got an armored car and we got two tanks here.
Cooked inside this thing.
2 BT-7s and a BA-10. So I'm going to move these BT-7s onto the bridge. Or at least one of them onto the bridge. Looks like we got a nice little cinematic here as we advance them across the map. So you can tell they're obviously trying to be a little bit more visually stunning than other sort of traditional games in this genre. We've got an armored car, recon car we'll send across the bridge as well. And then I'm going to leave this tank here on the other side of the river, just in the event that the Japanese troops here north of the further north might try and go for our bases. So I'm going to go ahead and move these tanks on that road here to protect against potentially a flank attack from the Japanese that are already across the river on the other side. I'm also not clear when the units that I purchased will show up. I don't know if maybe I just didn't... Let's see here. Does it... So I purchased this regular unit. Is there an option to deploy? Or do I just have to wait for a while? Like, if we acquire a unit, it doesn't seem to tell me how long it will take for that unit to show up. But I don't see anything about, like, upcoming units or units that are under construction or anything like that. It's also kind of a tutorial-type mission, so... Oh, they're in reserve.
What's your command?
So I'm going to deploy these guys to the map as well. You can see there was a reserve option down here on the lower part of the screen.
We'll
and then
make
I'm
going to
move.
Pay.
Well, I can't move them. I can't deploy them and move them the same turn. So we're working on repelling the Japanese attack. We've destroyed two of three units. We have to hold the Soviet army foothold. We'll end the turn again. You can see the Germans or the Japanese try to advance there. Our anti-tank gun just obliterated that armored unit there. Samurai.
Comrades, now is not the time to celebrate. My agents say the Japanese have now crossed the Halkin goal near the Bain Saigon Mountain. They are digging in there. The samurai can strike at your rear at any moment.
Okay, so it looks like we're going to have to engage these troops here on the other side of the river, just like I had sort of expected.
We can't just throw our tanks at the Japs. The samurai will burn them. First, we need to soften up their infantry with attacks from the air. Then we should send in the tanks, but only with the...
Okay.
You are far too timid for a cavalry commander.
This back and forth is just kind of humorous.
The workers and peasants, but do as you wish. I hope the units you have will be enough to storm Bain Saigon.
Okay, so it does look like we get some more units now. We've got some air units. Is it nighttime now? This is weird. Looks like it's nighttime. But it looks like we've got some air units here. So we've got a tactical bomber here. We'll go ahead and fly against this enemy here.
The anti-aircraft units overwatch and fire support.
There could be enemy anti-aircraft guns. I guess we'll see. But I'm going to go ahead. Yep, ambushed.
Do not leave your tactical bombers without protection. Remember, they are prime target for enemy fighter planes.
Bird of steel. Gonna fly my I-16 over here in front of these guys. See if maybe we can strafe them, hurt their entrenchment a little bit.
But not for long.
Going to now send my tactical bombers here against these dug-in enemy guns.
This is a long-range bomber. It has higher fuel capacity and more defense, but lower attack parameters due to the higher altitude of bombing runs. Such bombers are better escorted with long-range fighters.
We also get some extra troops up here in the north. I can't really tell, like, this is very poorly... I feel like this is very poorly laid out.
Aim well, hit hard.
Nighttime imagery. Yeah, we'll leave the artillery in place. Like, I can't see anything, which is, I guess, that's nighttime, but it doesn't do a good job of making things visible for a player. Alright, we'll move our armor here. We've got some infantry on the flank with the armor here. We're going to move our new tanks that we just purchased over here.
Your unit has been withdrawn from a supply zone. The delivery of supplies to the unit has been stopped. The supply zone is marked with a white box symbol
okay.
in the upper corner of each.
So they're outside of supply now. They're no longer in a supply zone. So I guess that's what these arrows represent and these particular boxes
Where to
represent.
Now, Comrade Commander?
I don't want to attack with my tanks in the night, though.
They'll
also, let's also
land.
Pull some of our armor back from the other side of the bridge here. We'll crush these guys. Fear not. I don't know if they're going to make another attack on our position on this side of the road or not. Artillery sure seems powerful in this game, though. We'll leave the anti-tank guns, the armored cars, and the infantry on the other side of the road.
Packed with proletarian fury.
Packed with proletarian fury. Nice. I'm going to bring my artillery back on the other side of the bridge, and we'll use it to pound these Japanese positions that we're supposed to attack. Hopefully we're going for a little bit of overkill here. That's the objective.
We're in a tank.
Yeah, okay.
Ready for some havoc.
Doesn't look like I can
Hopefully,
move these guys.
No fighters today.
Oh, actually I can.
Where to, Commander?
But I can't move those guys.
Fighter planes are vital for gaining air superiority.
Okay.
Keep your fighters close to allied aircraft you want to protect, and they will provide fire support. Fighters are able to attack.
All right, let's end the turn. I don't need to listen to you talk anymore. All right, so it still says we need to hold the Soviet Army foothold, so I do assume that means that we need to hold the other side of the river, so it's probably a good thing I left some of my troops on
it
the other side of
like
the river.
It seems like the Japanese fighter pilots are getting an upper hand against
that
one. Okay,
the
blah, blah, blah. Stop. I don't need all of that instruction, guys. All right, so the Japanese do have some have more fighters than us.
Fast.
Do we have any anti-aircraft guns? Looks like we have more fighters than I thought. All right, so we'll swing in behind these guys with our fighters.
It's a tough job,
We got some overstrength units by the looks of it. We're going to lose more units than they are.
It's anti-aircraft overwatch fire.
I know there's anti-aircraft.
It's costly to attack enemy positions protected by anti-aircraft units. Try making a preliminary attack on the enemy anti-aircraft units to disable their overwatch ability before sending any aircraft squadrons to engage them.
Can we just shoot these guys? Oh, shit. I didn't want to fly there. Undo that move.
Say your prayers.
All right, we're going to fly our fighters back.
Anyone call for divine intervention? Squash the earth.
I should have bombed the anti-aircraft guns from the beginning, although I wonder if their fighters are going to attack me as I try and attack the anti-aircraft.
This target has the fire support of enemy fighter planes.
Yeah.
It's costly to attack any enemy plane next to an enemy fighter.
On our way.
Motherland's finest.
Run or be removed. Squash the
earth. All right, let's go ahead and attack this anti-aircraft gun again. Their fighters are going to hurt our bombers, but I'm hoping that I can weaken their anti-aircraft guns enough that at least our next turn, whatever survives, won't be too badly hurt. Afterburners? Really? All right, we'll land that fighter. I'm assuming we can replenish it or repair it or something like that.
Ready to roll all over them.
All right. Our artillery is still up here, isn't it? It's not in range yet, so we're going to go ahead and move these guys a little bit closer. Let's move them one more hex.
Yes, Comrade Commander.
So hopefully they can attack next turn. We'll also move our anti-aircraft guns in here to see if we can't attack the enemy fighters.
Protect your forces from enemy aircraft.
Well, I guess actually they have to stay limbered up, so we'll move them a little bit more slowly.
Large caliber anti-aircraft artillery is a good weapon for destroying enemy tanks.
Okay, that's 2-0 against us, 1-1 against them. Let's coordinate this attack here a little bit. So I'm going to move this artillery. God damn it, it's just barely out of range.
Covering ground. Tank crew awaiting orders.
All right, let's move our armor and infantry forward here.
Form up.
What is your command?
You can hide, but you can't run from a shell.
I mean, you can run from a shell. Don't tell me that, game. So we're going to continue holding here. We do want to capture this Japanese village over here as well. Is there anything I haven't moved yet? I'm going to completely overwhelm these guys.
We die together.
1-1, 1-1.
Ready and able.
Ready to roll.
I guess we'll just
them.
Try and overwhelm these guys and just attack with a lot of our armor against these dug-in Japanese troops.
Where the fire support of the enemy artillery.
Standing by for orders. Ready to roll all over them.
Doesn't look like I can attack that.
They'll regret coming to our land.
All right, so a lot of pithy comments from the different Soviet soldiers. We weaken their infantry pretty heavily. I'm thinking we'll finish the attacks on this enemy base here on the next turn. Probably going to lose a fair amount of bombers to these Japanese fighters here. Looks like their artillery shot against some of our armor over there. Some of their fighters are pulling back, probably the ones we badly damaged. All right, so it's May 15th.
Tank crew on standby.
Artillery should be in range now, so we'll go ahead and attack the enemy artillery with my own artillery. Apparently there's a sudden attack benefit, and the enemy artillery is almost destroyed. They're down to two.
Guns
my other artillery piece here is going to fire at the enemy infantry here. They will get enemy counter-battery fire, but I figured it would be more worthwhile
where
to go after
now,
what's left of the infantry.
Tank,
we'll actually go after
duty.
The artillery here. Opening with our armor.
Blasted to
wipe
pieces.
It out.
Ready to
I don't know if all units
all
always
them.
Surrender, or if that's... I'm not quite sure what that's all about.
Opening fire.
Okay, so we wiped out that... I thought we wiped out that enemy infantry,
prepare
but maybe
to
not.
Move out. Infantry, double file.
Move the infantry forward here.
Get
have them finish
comrades.
Off this enemy infantry.
Making tracks.
Move our own tanks forward here.
For the motherland.
Attack the enemy anti-aircraft guns.
I'm getting cooked inside this thing. For the motherland. Load up.
Oof, that was bad. Close
we
in
fight together,
fighting
we
enemy infantry,
together.
Perhaps with
tactical
with
reporting.
Oops, undo. Close in fighting enemy infantry with our own Tanks may not be the wisest. Where did I... So I landed my fighters here, right? At this airbase? Aircraft. So these guys were three. It looks like they replenished themselves somewhat up to five.
Orders received.
So I'm going to take my fighters off and see if I can't go engage these Japanese fighters.
Guns of the Soviet Union.
Runner, be removed.
All right, we'll go pull these tactical... I don't need to... We'll pull these bombers back and have them land. I'll move these fighters... Well, can our anti-aircraft hit them? They can. Okay, so I'll attack these enemy fighters with my anti-aircraft first.
We'll blast them to pieces.
Then I'll pull in my... my fighters here. Go after these Japanese fighters. It says 1 to 5, so that should be a pretty good chance of success here.
They're running for their lives.
All right, so they're retreating because they're demoralized. But we'll see if we can't finish them off with our fighters, and we do. All right, let's go bomb these enemy anti-aircraft guns. All right, so we destroyed those. Let's go bomb these Japanese infantry here, just to hopefully hurt them a little bit.
Fighters of the Soviet Air Force.
We'll go ahead and strafe these enemy anti-aircraft guns that are retreating and finish them off.
Just point the gun towards the enemy. At once, Comrade
Commander. Armor forward here.
Taking aim.
Attack the enemy infantry at a little bit of a distance. Do a little bit of damage to them.
It's hunting season.
We detected multiple Japanese troops on the other side of the river
tank
here.
Reporting for duty. Tank crew on standby. We fight together, we die.
All right, 1 to 4, close defense.
Every time a unit with nice. An overrun skill defeats an enemy unit, it gains the ability to move and attack again.
All right, so we apparently gained an overrun trait. We just went in and took the enemy base here.
Is that where the fighting is? Just point the gun towards the enemy.
Doesn't look like I can quite finish the enemy off here.
We fight together, we die together.
Yes, Comrade Commander.
Guns artillery south as well. Looks like there's two more enemy units here. Enemy supply point there. These are the hexes we need to take. I don't really have a lot of cash to, like, call in new units or anything like that. So I think I've kind of got what I'm gonna get for the rest of the scenario. So we'll go ahead and move forward another turn. Looks like the enemy might have moved some troops back into these entrenchments, which would make sense. It's nighttime
infantry
again, by the way. We'll have our infantry finish theirs off.
Flawless capture.
Then we'll move ahead
also
and take the base.
That grabbed Bayan Sagan,
so we wipe them out.
Congratulations.
Now we need to push the invaders out of Mongolia, advance to the northeast, and capture the 23rd Infantry Supply Depot as well as the Stone Cairn.
My reports indicate fresh Japanese troops are preparing to cross the Hulkan Gold north of the Bain Saigon.
Thank
okay.
you for the warning.
So, more enemy troops on the way here in the north.
Tank crew awaiting orders.
I don't need the, like, cinematic shift of the camera all the time.
We fight together, we die together.
So I'm going to move three tanks north against this bridge if there really are new Japanese troops that are about to cross the river. I'm also going to move some
tank
of my troops here toward this base.
Be there in a minute, Comrade Commander.
We won't move their
artillery
maximum range
standing by.
Yet, anyway.
Quiet. Comrade Commander is speaking.
Move some recon here to the crossroads. Nice. Okay, so we detected some enemy unit over here.
We're attacking improvise.
So I'm not sure what that enemy unit is, but there's something over there.
Fire from the sky.
Yeah. Fire
all
from the sky.
Quiet, but not for long.
Some of these comments by these, I don't know, characters or
we
icons when you click on them is kind of a little bit annoying.
Ready to make some craters. Dropping bombs.
All right, so there's two enemy infantry units and an enemy armored unit over here by the looks of it.
Wish mine pop could see this.
Wish your pop could see this? What are you, American?
You can hide, but you can't run from a shell.
Move this artillery up here to support the armor advancing in the north.
Motherland's armor! Understood.
All right. I can't really tell. There's, looks like we've got some anti-aircraft guns, so we'll move them there. All right, so move these guys north. Let's also advance our infantry toward the base, the supply base.
Anti-tank artillery is effective against tanks and other hard targets. Your best tactic when using anti-tank artillery is to position it next to your other forces.
So advance it off that bridgehead now.
Versus attacks from enemy tanks.
And that'll do it for this turn, I think. Enemy fighters are coming back out to play. Their fighters are not very good. Or at least they're taking a lot of heavy casualties. Meanwhile, their armor's going to make an attack on our anti-aircraft guns, which are on trucks. And it looks like they are making a move to counterattack us at this bridgehead.
Comrades, my agents report a plane carrying a Japanese high-ranking officer crashed.
Okay, so we're getting a bunch of different information, different objectives sort of showing up. Japanese armor in the north did try and move across the bridge, but they were ambushed by our own armor.
Hope our folks back home are all right.
All right, we'll go ahead and pound these guys with artillery first.
Where to now, Comrade Commander?
Go ahead and hit these guys with our armor. Lose a little bit of casualties, but we wipe out the enemy unit.
Inside this thing. Just point the gun towards the enemy.
Hope we have enough ammo.
They want you to come.
All right, let's see if we can't finish off this enemy fighter.
Your aircraft are out of ammunition. In order to rearm, your aircraft has to land an airfield within supply zone.
All right, so we're going to go ahead and pull our aircraft back to land at that airbase. You know what we're going to do is I think we're going to have to pull all of our air units back. So we're just going to pound these enemy armored units that are advancing on us. I might be able to wipe these guys out just from the air.
Hostiles are retreated. Pressure normal. Advancing is ordered.
All right, let's pull this fighter back.
Heard you, Comrade Commander.
Landed as well. I'm hoping the enemy doesn't have more fighters. We've destroyed two of theirs, so hopefully they don't have anything more to come at us. Let's pound this infantry here with artillery.
Your orders?
We'll attack these enemy tanks with our recon car there.
Let's find some enemy planes to shoot.
Anti-aircraft against these enemy infantry.
Die together. Hit confirm. Ready the high explosives.
Okay. Yeah, I'm not a big fan of these textures. It's very difficult to tell what the hell's going on. It's all very bright and shiny, but it's not very clear what the hell is going on. All right, let's move these guys. They're going to be off supply, but they should. I'm hoping they have elevation. By the looks of it, these guys should have elevation and can fire down on these Japanese troops, which appear to be dug in. Apparently, they don't have a line of fire there, so I was mistaken.
Front of a key, awaiting orders.
When in doubt, improvise. Oh, I see.
Move our recon out over here. What is this? Enemy artillery?
We'll punch right through them.
We'll make them pay. Squad is on the move.
My squad apparently mounts up in trucks.
Our knives are sharp.
Also, it looks like there might be minefields.
Here to hunt some tough rats. Our aim won't falter.
Any more troops on that side of the river?
Standing by for orders.
Alright, let's pull back here.
We're in a tank.
We've got a bunch of enemy infantry coming at us. I can't easily hit them with my own tanks because I guess the terrain, they're in like forest there, and it's very difficult for infantry to be hurt by armor and forests. We're going to go ahead and pull our Air Force units here all back. Actually, we'll leave this one air unit. It's got good supply and good fuel. We'll leave it out over these tactical bombers. Also, I think I have one more aircraft, one more tactical aircraft, which is sitting in the base. All right, guys, this first scenario is actually going to be a little bit of a longer one, so I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up here. We'll split this first episode into two parts. That way it's not like an hour and 10-minute long episode. Let me know your thoughts down below, and if you like this or if this looks interesting. I have like this secret guilty pleasure that I love these cutscenes. As bad as they are, as terrible as the voice acting is, it is like really amusing in a way. There's a lot of instruction that I don't know that is necessary. I wonder if you can turn that off, or maybe at higher difficulty levels it turns off some of the dialogue in the middle of the scenario. I think that gets in the way of things a little bit. I also think the actual map, the color scheme is a little bit difficult to follow. Like, the units really blend into the ground. The day-night phases, it's very difficult to tell units apart. I think that's a major weakness of the game and could get really frustrating over an extended playthrough. But overall, I am enjoying my initial look here at Spectre, or Strategic Mind Spectre of Communism, which comes out today. Let me know your thoughts down below, though. And we will come back for at least one more episode to finish up this initial scenario. Until then, though, this is the Historical Gamer saying once again, thank you very much for watching, and until next time, I'm out.